Well, it's the sound we hear when severe weather hits. The sirens are set off to alert us to dangerous conditions nearby. But with today's technology, are these sirens indeed the best way to get a warning out to the public?
Well, that is a good question tonight. And Fox 59's Lindsay Eaton is getting some answers from the experts. She's also talking to someone whose home was destroyed by a tornado.
Mother Nature, in my opinion, is the most powerful force there is.
Go, Jake, get out of here.
You can't get away from it. You can't get away from a tornado.
With seconds to spare, Taylor Glenna barely made it to cover when the tornado hit Kokomo back in 2013.
I thought it was coming at me. I mean, I didn't think I was going to live that day.
None of us should have made it through any of that.
Indiana is in one of the four regions considered a tornado alley. Researchers even named it after our state, Hoosier Alley.
In Indiana, you know, we're no strangers to them.
Or to the sound before them. When the National Weather Service issues a tornado warning, Marion County Emergency Management activates the sirens.
It is meant to say that it's imminent in your area that there is a tornado.
And that you should seek shelter immediately. The sirens are for everyone's safety, but specifically designed for those who may be outside without a phone or any other means of communication.
We want to make sure that we're reaching everybody.
Where you see the smiley faces.
There are 171 sirens throughout Marion County. They are all tested weekly. It costs $70,000 a year for repairs and maintenance.
So here at 62nd and Cooper Road, you have one.
But are these sirens the most effective way to alert the public that danger is near? It's a question that's been debated.
You can make a case that the sirens aren't a good idea, because more often than not, they draw people outside to see, hey, what's going on? When you want people to be indoors and sheltered.
Fox 59's chief meteorologist Brian Wilkes tracks all the weather statistics year after year.
It is suspiciously quiet.
And he knows this year, severe weather so far has been practically silent.
We went through the entire month of April without a tornado warning being issued from the National Weather Service in Indianapolis. That hasn't happened in an April in 7 years. And what I think will end up happening is that we're going to flip the switch at some point.
And Hoosiers need to be ready when it happens. That means not relying solely on the sirens.
I'm not saying get rid of the sirens. You know, we need them, but you need to have multiple ways of getting warnings. You cannot say that enough.
Get a weather radio and download reliable apps like our Weather Authority app so you can get weather alerts set right to your phone as soon as they happen.
Better to be overprepared than underprepared, especially when you're dealing with tornadoes.
So as technology constantly evolves, will sirens become a thing of the past?
In my lifetime, I think they'll still be here. But as technology gets, you know, better, which is pretty good right now, I can see there being other methods other than just the tornado siren to be the primary way to notify people.
I think as many warnings as possible, that, you know, they can put sirens, the text message alerts. I think the more the better.
When you look at what's left.
Fox 59 crews were on South Bell Street soon after the tornado hit. There's now only a fence here on this corner lot where Taylor's home used to be.
They said it moved 42 feet off the foundation. Our carport was two blocks away, and our shed, they never really could find it.
Taylor remembers hearing the sirens that day and admits he wasn't too concerned until it was almost too late.
We couldn't see anything.
Now, when severe weather hits, Taylor doesn't hesitate. He's been there, he's seen it, and he has felt the unmatched power of Mother Nature.
It could happen to anyone. I mean, I didn't think it could happen to me, but it did. And thank God we took cover when we did.
In Kokomo, Lindsay Eaton, Fox 59 News.
You got to be prepared. The best way to keep updated, by downloading our Weather Authority app. You can get weather alerts sent straight to your phone. It is free in your device's app store.